Hey everyone, I'm Nog and welcome back to Satisfactory. In this episode, we are going to get our next tier started. As you can see, I have brought all of the basic materials up from down here, and they're running along the side of the building here, and then over here, they start coming up and going into wall pieces. So we'll be getting them up here and then we'll start building up here. But first, I want to go craft some of the slugs into things that can upgrade our speed a bit. I don't remember what they're called, so let me just see. Power shards, that's what they're called. So let's just craft all our slugs into power shards. Now we have 7, and then we have 2 yellow ones. So we now have 11 power shards, which is really nice. So that's done. And what I think I want to do actually is speed up the process at the bottom so that it comes out faster at the top eventually. But since we have all of these coming in on this side, all of our materials coming in on this side, we have iron plates over here, then we have rods, screws, wire, and cable down at the end here. So I had to move it down here to the end because we have the entrance to the floor here, so it was kind of blocked off, but that's okay. So what I'm gonna do is I wanna disassemble all of these and I want to actually build them the other way. So let's do that. We'll start over here. And get them up and running. So I want to have it something like this. Let's see, how much space do I need? I think I want to have a couple of spaces in between, or a couple of foundations in between. So we'll put one down here. And we'll just build them out like this. See how many we can get in there. This one will probably encroach, so let's just delete that. And can't afford. Okay. Never mind. We'll just build these for now. What am I missing? Here, I have a lot of stuff. What does it take to build them? I'm missing rotors. That's okay. We can live with this for now. But let's see, what do we want to build here? I want to build reinforced iron plate in this one, I think. And I want 2 reinforced iron plate machines going, I'm pretty sure. And so let's do that for now. And then I want to build rotors, which I think for now we'll just do one maybe. And then we need to make modular frames, but we'll do that further forward. So let's do rotors here as well. Build 2 of those, and then we can take that out for now. So that's 4 machines. And we actually need screws for all of it. So we're going to need to craft more screws, I think. And get them up here somehow. Or we could just... I think what we'll do is we will use some power shards and increase the production. I'm not actually sure that we will ever need copper again, but we'll find out. But let's get... this thing going. What I want to do is build a stackable conveyor pole. Do something like this. And get this going up there. And then I want another stackable conveyor pole. Right around here, I think. And then we will get this going in here, and it's too steep. So let's move them forward a little bit more. Because what I want to be able to do is I want to have this clear so that I can just run underneath and not have to jump around. So let's build the assembler a little bit further forward. Something like this, maybe? Let's try it there. And see if this will now go into there. It will. Fantastic. Alright, so, and then we need screws for that as well. So I think what I will do is, again, we will put the stackable conveyor pole right in front of the screws here. There. And we'll get the screws up there. And build another stackable conveyor pole. I think it's there. Looks like it's there. And get screws going across. And what I think I will do is, this is going to be problematic. I think I want a splitter somewhere around here. You're probably going to have to move the machine forward a bit more. That's okay. Trial and error is a reasonable way of doing things. So let's get that in there. And we will move this forward even more. Move it up here, I think. Delete that. And then we have this going. I think it needs to go up a bit. And to over here. Let's see, can this belt go up there? Yes, it can. Great. And then it can go in there. And I think we will build one more hole here. And a ford, we need iron rods. So let's just grab some if we can here. Whoops. It would probably be faster to go down and get some, but for right now, I just want to get this one thing going so that we see if that it actually works the way I want it to. So, stackable conveyor pole there. This will come into that, and then it'll come down and go into that. And this needs a recipe, which is reinforced iron plate. And then it just needs some power. So let's just try that. Give it some power and see that it works. We can just do like that for now. And it does. It's going, but it needs way more screws than we're producing. Way, way more. So we need to get our conveyor belts Mark II in there. Which will get it going a bit faster there, but we need it all the way. Can't afford. But we can grab one here now. Yay! One. Alright, this is gonna take a while. But that's okay. That is perfectly okay. Who can't afford it? Didn't I just grab one? Yeah, I did. Why can't I afford it? One more. Let's try this. What about Mach 2? Can't afford. Can't afford. That is weird. Because it just needs one reinforced iron plate. And I have two reinforced iron plate. So let's just try and delete these two. And build it and see if we can afford it now. Can't afford. Okay. This is getting a little bit frustrating. Come on. There we go. Alright. We have one more? Yes, we do. Probably need one more. And now it's not getting screws. Do we have some screws on us that we can feed to it? Yes, we can. There. Make some reinforced iron plate. And we need to do this the entire way, because all of this is Mach 1 belts, but I won't make you sit through that. I will do that off camera, upgrade everything to Mach 2 belts. Alright. Let's see now. Now we have three of these. Can we do it? Yes, we can. Alright. So now it's feeding in, but it won't actually be coming any faster, I think, because it'll just be spaced out more. But eventually, when we get everything upgraded, it will. So the plates are fine for now, at least. Uses 20 per minute. This is running at 68% capacity right now, because we fed in the screws, so it will go up. But at least we are producing reinforced iron plate now, which is really nice. So what we can do is we can set up another machine to produce that. And I think we'll do that right now. Where do I want it? Let's just build it here. So we can run through here. It seems like we don't need that much space on this level. So let's get some iron plate here. We need to get our hole set up first. There. Then we need one over here as well. But for now we'll just use the splitter to get this in here. So let's see, let's go in and take the Mach 2, stick that in there. Then we want some more poles, like so. And then we can go under and in, I think. That'll be fine because we have our running space here. This over here doesn't actually need to be elevated. It isn't here anyway. So, yeah. So let's get this hooked up. Oops. It's not what I wanted at all. Where'd this thing go? It looks a little bit weird. Go from there to there, please. And then we can go from there to down here. That. And in there. And get this thing set up with a recipe. And let's take out this power line. And build some power poles over here so that we are doing things right. There. And then we can hook up this power line to there, this one to there, one to there, and that one there. So we have two machines producing reinforced iron plate. One that will go into becoming frames, and one that will go into just storage, which is nice. So we'll probably need to expand on this at a later date, but that's okay. I actually rather enjoy getting all of these setups going and just watching things work. That's quite enjoyable to me. Alright, so these guys are going. We might as well grab that and grab whatever is over here. 17, not bad. It sure beats handcrafting them. So we might have wanted to build this a little bit closer together, but we have plenty of space and we can always expand out this way and go on top of this building down here, which will be concrete and biofuel and stuff like that. But let's just see how much power are we actually using now. I think quite a bit. So around half of our available megawatts is being spent at the moment, more or less. So yeah, we'll probably need some more coal generators as well. Let's build one here as well. Can go right next to it, I think. And let's see, we want rotors. And we need iron rods and screws for that. Now we have the second line of screws here, and we have iron rods there, which we need to bring over and into this one. So let's start by doing that. And we will take the far away rod machine here. And bring this up here. And then I think I'll put a pole on top of that and put one up here as well. Let's see, where do we want it? There. Oh, can't afford. I need more rods. Let's just go grab some. We won't need that many to get this done. No, that's not rods. That's rods. Alright. So, 4. And we want it here. And we want it to go up there. Alright. So, let's just do this. If it needs to be upgraded to Mark II, I'll do it off camera, so you don't have to be pained by that process. Up there, and this one will go in there, like so. And then we will need the screws, which we will need more of these poles for. There. And it can actually go into there, I think, without any trouble. And then need just one here. And that'll be fine. So, screws. Uh, Actually, let's just make the screws Mach 2 belts straight away, because it seems like we're going to need a lot of screws for everything that we do. Encroaches are the clearance, then we will do like this. And get it going in there. Alright. So this is set up, and we already configured it, we just need power, which we will get by putting down a power pole here. And then we actually need to tear down this power line and hook it up again. There we go. We should be producing rotors now. Once it gets enough screws, 22 screws. That is a lot of screws. But yeah, we are producing rotors. Very nice. And you can build another rotor machine here. Let's see, can we get a splitter in for the screws here? We can, maybe. Yes, we can. Hook it up like that. Let's build the machine. And Mach 2 conveyor belt. Alright. Oh. Grab some reinforced iron plate. And stick this in here. That'll be fine. And then we need rods. I think we're producing enough rods on one machine, I think. So I think we'll stick a splitter up here. Then we will put a conveyor pole down here. And where is it? There. And get this going that way. And come in there. And we need to configure this to rotors, and we need to power it up. So again, just tear this power line down and hook it up again. So, and like so. There we go. We're making more rotors. Very nice. So this hole here is going to bother me a little bit now, but I'll just have to manage it for now. But we are definitely producing, and that is very, very nice. Excellent. We actually have 7 rotors in there. We have 2 iron reinforced iron plate in there, and 3 in there, and all right, everything is looking a little bit better. Still a little bit better. So let's run down here. I know we need to set up the frames as well, but I really want to up the production of some stuff. So let's just run down here. Let's see, we have this iron is not going yet. So what we could do is get that going and then drop one of these being split off. I think we want to do that. And I think we have another iron patch back here. somewhere. Yeah, it is iron. Indeed it is. So we can actually get four normal iron ore miners up and running, which means that we can get them all going into each, to one smelter each, because we're using four iron ore smelters, I think, or are we using six? We're using six, aren't we? This is iron ore. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah. So, but at least we can get four of them running on their own, and maybe we can find some more iron ore patches somewhere and bring in, so that we run full belts of iron ore in each, which I would very much like to do. Very, very much like to do. So yeah, let's just have a look at our production here. So you are backing up, but if we stick a power shard in there and double your production, then I think you will not be backing up anymore at all. But you will be filling up a full belt of MK1s now, because they can take 60 plates a minute, and actually it's only half a belt, but we're using 60 iron ingots a minute. So what we need to do is, and this is producing how many iron ingots a minute? It's producing 30 per minute. So what we can do is give this two power shards as well, double that production, and get that producing 60 iron ingots per minute. But that will mean that it's not getting enough iron ore, so we need to go to stop the splitting and get more iron smelters up and running. But this is actually really nice. It does use up a whole lot more power. So we can see before it was using 4 megawatts, now it's using 12.1. I think it was using 4 at least. Let's just check it. 4, yeah. So it's tripled the power up consumption and doubled the output. So it's not power efficient by any means, but it works. And that's what I really want right now. So yeah, and we can't double this again, unfortunately. So, but what we could do then is set up another machine and actually combine two machines on one belt, giving us 60 iron plates per minute, which I think is what we will want to do eventually. So this machine could go over here, and then we could have another, could maybe fit another two machines in here, making iron plate, giving us two full belts of iron plate coming out of here, which would be really, really sweet. So yeah, so I think now that we have the reinforced stuff going a little bit, I think what we'll do in the next episode is we will go and explore a lot, because I want to find more power slugs so that we can optimize this whole production process as much as possible, and get everything flowing at the correct levels and so on. How is the power doing now? Actually, it seems like we're using less power, which is a little bit weird since we've overclocked stuff and so on. But I don't mind that. Now here it comes a little bit. Then it goes down again. Okay. We'll figure out what's going on there eventually. Let's, I want to grab this stuff. And I really, really like that we're just able to pick this out of here. We'll of course set up storage for these guys as well, backup storage, and we will then move on to the next level. Of course, we need to set up our frame production and so on, but we'll do that at a later time, because right now I want power shards and I want to go exploring. So in the next episode we will be exploring. I don't know which way we'll go. We'll see. We won't go over to where the coal is. We've kind of seen a lot of that, although there was a cave over there that we could go explore maybe. But we could also go just a completely different way and see what's around us. And I think that is probably what we're going to do. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.